Hello, my name is David Soler, and I come from Barcelona in Spain. And I've been, I came 10 years ago in the US, and now I'm a postdoc at Case Western Reserve University Department of Dermatology under the direction of Dr. Kevin Cooper. And basically, I do skin research focusing on psoriasis and another type of skin dermatitis that is particularly insidious, and it affects only the hands and the feet of those suffering it, and it's called pamphylix, or also called dyshidrotic eczema. Since last year, it was a very productive year. We got two publications, and I won my first peer review grant. And although it was not a lot of funding, it allowed us to create these two transgenic animal models for aquaporin overexpression and test. These are one of the hypotheses that I want to test regarding the pamphylix disease, that the exposure to water is what makes this disease chronic. So this disease is very particularly socially wrecking because it affects the hands and the feet of those suffering it, so that it impacts your social quality of life. And it would be, you know, it would be okay if the disease would go away, but unfortunately, the disease chronifies over time. So there have been people that they have been living all their life with this disease. So I'm trying to see why this disease doesn't go away. And one of the ideas that I got is that there is like maybe a problem in the osmotic balance of the skin. Because I noticed that this disease was particularly prevalent on people that was constantly exposed to water, like nurses, like doctors, and like handymen. So this has been published in the literature. So there seemed to be like a predisposition for those people that they have water in their hands. And I'm trying to model this disease with these animal models to overexpress these aquaporins that basically are the water pipes of the cells in the body. So they basically transport water across membranes, and I'm trying to see if the osmotic gradient, when you touch water and you dry your hands and you touch water again, because normally people averagely, they water their hands like 8 times daily, you know. So I'm trying to test this in mice, and we'll see. Maybe next year I will have some more conclusive answers. One event that I like it so much, it was this minorities event that they created this speed networking round table. So basically you would go and you would meet a lot of people in very few time, and actually this is one of the best opportunities to use this this meeting to try to, you know, expand your network of contacts and colleagues. So in this regard, I think it was much better than last year. The best speaker I've seen, maybe Mark Jenkins that gave the first session, the opening at the first day, because he actually, I had the time to talk to him on the roundtable session, the minorities affair session, and he basically, you know, he does very well. He's aware that that people attention span is pretty short, and that he also believes in these four items at a time mantra, that you know people cannot process more than four figures in one slide. And his talk, he intertwined like you know, serious research with like little breaks, so that people kind of reset and then, you know, picked up again at the same attention. And I think it was a very, very nice example of how to engage the audience during like a long time of maybe like over an hour. So I think it was a good speech. I think it's a great opportunity to meet new people, to establish more contacts, because, you know, everybody lives in the aisle of the laboratory, and even in the inside institution, you know, it's pretty limited. So I think that's is one of the best chances. I would say the primary one is to be able to interact, because, you know, you need to, you know, to maximize your work, you need to interact with people. You know, that's how you're gonna go farther in this new age of research that is mostly team oriented. I mean, if you are yourself, you cannot pull off enough researchers, resources, as if you have like a huge network of interaction and reagents and people that complement your techniques with yours. So I think that's the place to meet this new type of people.